Hello, welcome to Horror and Monster Collectibles, where today we're going to be taking a look at this new piece that I got in from Patrick McGee Effects, which is obviously, as you can see, a large goat head. So this is a life-size goat head, and it is made using a dense urethane. It has resin horns and custom acrylic eyes. The hair is done by a unique transfer, like a fur transfer method that McGee uses. And then also a combination of hair punching and gluing hair, and it's mounted on a wooden base. I'm super stoked about this. I wanted something unique for the collection, and I feel like I found it with this. So let's go ahead and spin this around and take a closer look. All right, so this measures out at about 15 inches tall and about 18 and a half inches wide. Let's dig in for a closer look. We'll start with the eyes here. He does offer two eye variants that you can choose from. You can do the dead white, which I did, and you can also choose a red evil twist on a traditional goat eye. I kind of settled on this one just because I like the white. I really like the contrast between the darker eyelid and then that white eye. And it's hard to see, but there's even like a little pupil back here too. It's not really showing up on camera, but it's very faint. Again, it's just amazing work. And then speaking to that, I mean, just the sculpt around here and then even the goop from the eye that's gone down the fur here, and then just like dirt from like the environment the goat would have been in had it been real. Again, that's the amazing thing here. This is not a real goat. This is all his work. And of course we have the same thing down through here and then even on the nose. So we'll kind of start here at the top. And the technique that he uses, I'm sure that he guards that secret very well, but it works very well for him. Like he's got this down pat. Look over here at the horns. So again, these are resin. Come back here to the back side of the horns. I don't know if these were cast from real horns though. I feel like that would have been probably the easiest and simplest way to get this look. If he's just sculpted this out from scratch, then kudos to him, because he did just a phenomenal job. I mean, you can just see like all the growth rings on here. It's pretty freaking spectacular. Coming here through the ear, down here to the side, and I love the mouth here. I like the underbite that he's captured, and just the way the lips are. In some ways, it looks like it's kind of devilishly smiling, and in other ways, it looks like he's kind of frowning. But it's just amazing. All of the coloring on here, the modeling that he's done. It's just all top-notch work. I am a huge Patrick McGee fan. I have another piece that he is making for me right now, which I won't say anything on that just yet, but I'm super excited about it. It is a character from one of my favorite movies, horror movies growing up. And Super thrilled to be getting that from him. Let's take a look at the back. But again, it's just phenomenal work. It's just so great. Like, I love the asymmetrical horns. Like, to me, that just looks, it looks so real and natural. You wouldn't know that this thing wasn't real. In fact, I made an Instagram post, and like, I got a lot of PMs or DMs from people asking if it was a real goat's head. It is not, though. But man, it certainly does look like it. And then all of the hair down here. It's, I don't know if you guys have ever spent any time around goats, but it is that same coarse hair that goats have. And it's just phenomenal. Even like throughout here, it's softer. I mean, it's a lot like petting a real goat, which is kind of weird. But it is. And we'll come down here to the base. Now, the base is just a standard wood, stained wood base with a galvanized pipe that goes up into the head. The head just sits down on there. There's just a recess in the bottom of the head, and that's how you display him, which is super clean, and that's kind of like what I like. Just nice, clean, small, like not overly large base. But on him, you can get a lot of different angles and views on him, and he really kind of changes up on what direction you're viewing him at. But I feel like just straight on right there is my favorite. All right, so that's about all there is to go over on this goat head. Now, he does give you some cert stuff with it. You have this little piece, get in focus for you, that comes on the stand. And then he gives you this cert, and then it's signed by him on the back. And then you get a couple of a little fridge magnet. And then you get a couple little vinyl decals. This guy and then this guy, which is pretty cool. I do like just a nitpick thing. It would be nice to have a real nice official cert that you kind of frame up. Like, I think that would be cool. Hopefully in the future he starts doing that. But that would be my only nitpick on this. Again, this piece is absolutely phenomenal. It's a hyper realistic goat head. That's all made completely in-house, and it's crazy. It's super, super awesome. And again, like, I was looking for something different for the collection, something more unique, and this goat head just spoke to me. He was running a flash sale on the website, and so I'd been eyeing this for probably about 6 months or so, and I finally popped on it. He also has another head it's basically two goats conjoined. And I love that too, but I felt like I really love the silhouette of a goat head. There's something very cool about to me, and it could be because I've been a metalhead for 40 years, and it harkens back to all of that stuff, like from Venom and everything else, and goats in general, and like the whole dark stuff. This isn't a black goat, but like, think about like the witch and like Black Phillip and things like that. But I absolutely love this, and I think that this is super awesome. Again, there's nothing to nitpick here because it is flawless. He did just a phenomenal job. I have the Evil Dead 2 skull that he does. I think he calls it the Skull 2. And again, like, that's a great piece. But my big piece that I ordered from him will be here hopefully sometime soon, and I'm very, very excited about it. I can tell you that he just got in the eyes, the Four Seal Studio eyes for it, and that's all I'll say. As always, feel free to leave any questions or comments. Hopefully you dig this as much as I do. Again, it's something unique. It's something that you don't see every day. And while I love like all this horror stuff, I am a huge, huge, huge animal lover. Always have been, always will be. So to have this and it not be from an actual animal really makes me happy, because again, like, I am very, very adamant about cruelty to animals and stuff. I'm just a huge, huge animal lover, and I love that, like, I can have something cool like this and not feel guilty, or, well, I wouldn't even buy it if it was real, but I love that I can have something like this in my collection and it not be from an actual animal. So he still makes these. You can look up on his web store. If by chance he happens to take it down by the time you see this video, I would just send him a message and say, like, hey, you guys still doing the goat head? And I'm sure that they will get back with you as soon as possible. I will leave you with some studio shots on this. And as always, feel free to like and subscribe and click the bell for notifications for new videos. And until next time, I will see you guys later.